not in the stars. I'm not lucky. I just pray through it. Fall on my face. And
welcome, welcome, welcome to iHeartRadio. I am your host, Katris, right here on Pillow Talks every Sunday at 9 p.m. Eastern time. So tonight, you guys, I got family in the building. This is not only family, but this is boss kind of chick family. I'm so proud of her. So proud of her. So we're going to talk about do what you love to do. I titled Do What You Love to Do because I've seen this young lady. Her name is Jamaya Alexander. I've seen her walk it out and just really search the journey within herself to do what she loves to do. So welcome, Jamaya.
Hello, hello.
Yes, Jamaya's in the house. So, man, Jamaya, it's so good to have you here. You're so busy. Y'all, this is my niece, like I said before, and I can't keep up with her. Like, she, first, you know, I thought she was going to be on this journey with me, but I'm on a journey with her because she's doing so many things now. So, first of all, you're from Atlanta. Well, actually, you're from Charlotte.
Yes.
So then you all, they left me and they went to Atlanta and she came back ready to make some big moves.
Yes.
In your life. So first of all, tell me a little bit about what inspired you to go to cosmetology school.
Well, I mean, it kind of, a few factors played a part. When I first moved here, I didn't know what I wanted to do.
Right.
I kind of wanted to go back to school for dentistry.
Mm-hmm.
And I was on my way to do that, but then the courses were, like, already started. So I was just like, let me go to cosmetology school. It was kind of like a thought. But then I went with Aunt Jackie, and she got her hair done. And the guy who did her hair, he went to Paul Mitchell.
Mm-hmm.
So that was kind of like another, like, you know, nudge. That kind of, you know,
it inspired you when you was there?
That, okay, like, you know, go ahead and just go to cosmetology school, you know?
Wow. And I remember that day when she graduated, when she finished all of her. So first of all, she had many gifts, many talents that, you know, when we would do community events, I would tell her to bring her artwork, and she draws like crazy, you know. Of course, like I said, she was always involved, cheering, went to college, all that good stuff. And so when it was time for her to be, like, I know this is just one stop of many things in your life that you've started, but you have handled this well. So I remember her graduating, you guys, and we went to your ceremony. Was it at Paul Mitchell? It was Paul Mitchell.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and the way she came out and she owned it, you know, the fact that she finished. But a lot of people finish things, but we don't know how to move forward when we finish it. So we might graduate.
Yes.
We might, you know, finish a course. We might finish, you know, a program. But how to move forward after that, that is the real journey. That is the real decision that we have to make inside of us to do, to go forward. It's not just about getting to the finish line, but after you get into the finish line, you have to move forward beyond that finish line into destiny, into purpose. And so, you know, after you graduated, what would you think? Was you afraid? Did you understand, like, what was your next? Because I remember us talking, you was like, I want to do hair, but I don't know, like, you really wanted to focus on something specific. But you wanted to really focus on that. So tell me your thoughts and maybe the fears that came up. Because now you finished. You done paid this money.
Exactly.
You done told everybody you're doing hair. Exactly. So what were you thinking?
It was, at first, it was kind of a lot of pressure. Because Paul Mitchell is such a big name.
Mm-hmm.
And Paul Mitchell's like color and cutting.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of wanted to, I knew I didn't want to be in like a really big salon.
Right.
You know. I kind of wanted to go to like hair club for men, which is where they do like the like implants.
Okay.
And you get to work in your own space. So that was kind of like what was pushing me towards there. But then like after I graduated, I just kind of sat for a while because I still, you know, I knew I really didn't want to do that.
Okay.
So I was still braiding hair.
Uh-huh.
And I mean, that it just kind of,
but you was doing styles too, because I remember I was like, what is your focus?
I was
like,
because
I was trying to get my hair done. Dee was over there trying to get, we was like, what
was
you doing, Jamaya?
I was doing a little bit of everything. I wasn't sure. And that was my fear, because I didn't know where I wanted to be.
What turned you to braid? So she is the braided Goddess, that's the name of her yes. shop. Like, what made, like, this is a, like, this is a gift? Because I'm pretty sure, I don't know how your fingers work, but I can't be braiding. Like, I don't know how long that takes. First of all, I don't get my hair braided. I never have when I was a child because I don't want to sit for that long.
Yes.
You've never braided my hair, have you? And never will. But, you know, just tell me, you know, how did you choose braids? What was it about braids? Because if you go on her Instagram, you guys, Braided Goddess, you'll see that her lines, her technique is very, smooth with it. Mm-hmm. So what inspired you for just braids? I'm just going to do braids.
I guess it was just because that was the thing I did the most.
Yeah. Okay.
So
your clients was calling.
Mm-hmm. So it was so repetitive that I got really good at it. And you know, the other styles I did every now and then. Uh-huh. So I wasn't really able to perfect my craft in them.
Yeah.
So braiding just, it came like kind of naturally.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I went with it.
And she went with it. So she loved to go with stuff. First of all, Jamaya would jump up in a car, in a plane, and get moving on you. Like, you'd be like, where's Jamaya? Jamaya don't play that, so she ain't got no kids, for one, but just a little different than I was raised. Yeah. I didn't have kids young, but I wasn't so bold.
Yeah.
And I wasn't so, like, on fire and adventurous to just get up and go. Tell me some wonderful places you've been to. Like, you know, you have enjoyed your life.
Yes.
And you still are enjoying your life. Will you be, girl? I want to know.
So, most recently, I went to Vegas. That,
okay.
That was last year for my birthday.
During COVID?
Yes, but
very yeah, you
masked
safe.
Up.
I'm just
masked
saying, because
up.
Won't nothing hold her back. That's
no.
my point.
So, very safe. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Nightlife is definitely there.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed the weather for the most part.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Very comfortable.
On the boat? Did you go on the boat?
No.
Oh, that was trip.
So that was Aruba, which
oh.
was out of the country.
Yeah.
That was also very fun. I wish
yes.
I could have stayed a little longer, but it was very fun. I liked that trip too.
Yeah.
I went to Jamaica a while back on a cruise.
Uh-huh.
That was cool too.
Uh-huh.
It was nice to, you know, see and swim again.
Yeah.
This week on Thursday.
Oh my God. You didn't ask me about this. I don't know nothing about your life no more. I'm a little mad about this. I don't know. Let me drink some water. Go ahead.
I'm going to Houston.
Oh, what's
so
in Houston?
Excited. Honestly,
just a trip.
You know, a trip, but I plan on Houston is my next destination, I feel like. So
oh, you leaving me?
I feel like the next 2 weeks.
I'm going to visit,
and I'm excited to see it.
I love it.
Yeah, I
oh,
just want to
wow.
see what the atmosphere is there, because I feel
yeah.
like there's some things I can get done there.
Okay.
You know, some business things.
You know
so.
People already there? Do you know people?
I have one friend who moved out there a few years ago.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Wow. All right. So that was a little side note, just to let you know.
Sidebar.
This girl, little sidebar. Don't be correcting me on my
no,
show.
I said. So
listen, we're gonna take a little break, you guys. Stay with us, iHeartRadio. You're going to hear the rest of the story of her journey in Braided Goddess. I hadn't got to the good part yet, so we got one more good part to talk about with her business and with her adventure. All right, you guys, stay tuned. All right, you guys, thank you for staying right there tonight here on iHeartRadio. I am your host, Ms. Pillow Talks, Katris Wright, on Pillow Talks every Sunday at 9 p.m. So we're back with Jamaya. And Jamaya, we're talking about Braided Goddess. Tell them, if there's someone out there that needs you, how would they contact you? How do they find you?
I am on Instagram @BraidedGoddess_.
Mm-hmm.
You can also contact me by phone. And my number is 770-277-7930.
We sure about that?
I'm pretty sure that's the number, I think.
Okay. So first of all, you want to say that again?
Yes. Okay. Instagram is _BraidedGoddess_. And my phone number is
704-277-7930.
That's
it. She is 704. And I'm going to tell you about that number. That's her business number. Yes. First of all, that's why she don't know. She got a business phone, you guys, and I was texting her last night. She was like, who is this? Because I guess I get the main primary number, and because I got a, you know, I didn't even want to say it.
An iPhone.
No haters, y'all, iPhone. I'm switching over now, but I just, Androids, I love y'all. I still use it. But anyway, so she came back. She was like, who is this? Because I didn't give you my business number. So no. I was like, yes, you did.
No, it's because he was like, you was just like, normally when they call on the business phone, they'll say, hey, this is da 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 da. You're like, fine. Oh, hey, I like sent you. Da-da-da. I'm like, who is that?
Coming up professional on my line. Don't bring the ghetto on my line.
I'm like, you sent me what?
Oh, God. So anyway, so you guys got her number, you got her Instagram, and I'm laughing under this because it's getting foggy. So listen, iHeartRadio, so this next half, I want to talk about braided goddess, not only her styles, but what is it to be a business owner, and you are now in your own studio or suite.
Yes.
Here in Charlotte, North Carolina. You got your own space. Now you...
Thank God.
Praise God. Now, it ain't like she needed one because she was doing hair. You do need one, but you outgrew your living room.
Yes.
So, you know how sometimes we got to do what we got to do, right? Mm-hmm. So, when we're in business first, so you was doing hair in the home at first, and it was very professional. It was, you had your setup and all that. And then you was like, bump this by faith. I'm going out to get my own space and holding it down.
Yes.
I mean, holding it down, y'all, 100% legit. Legit. Tell me about that little process of when you felt like it's time for me to break up out of my comfort zone.
Yes.
And not only that, she quit a job, y'all.
Oh, yeah.
She let that thing go. Now, if you know my family, we like to work, so letting jobs go and gigs go and stuff like that is not always what we do.
Yeah.
We'll just keep adding on till we fall out one day now. But, you know, at the end of the day, you was like, bump this. I'm getting out of my comfort zone. Bump that little gig because there's more in me to do. And bump this space right here. I need my own.
Yes.
What hit you? What you drinking at night? I just want to know.
No, it was a process that was happening inside of me like probably for like a year. Because before I even could leave my family that I was nannying for, I had to become licensed, fully licensed.
Right, okay.
Which, that took me a long time because
To take your tests and do all that.
Fear of failure, you know.
Yeah.
You get in the space, you know, test taking is not my best.
That's a family thing.
Yeah, so I had to first get myself the courage to go in there and take the test and make sure I passed. So I
passed the test
first. So literally the day that I went and took the test, I decided that it was time to put in my 6-week notice with my family. So I took the test. I didn't even know if I passed yet.
Wow, that's fake. Papa taught you that.
Yes. I put my 6 weeks notice in, and even then, I was like, okay, you know, like, I'm taking the right steps.
Right.
Had to wait to make sure I passed, and then even after that, I was still doing hair out of the house, so I was still, like, you know, had to.
I got
okay. Even after that, I still had to make sure that I was going to be able to, of course, survive off of just doing hair alone.
Because
I was doing hair and nannying. So
I
had both going on. So that was another, you know, kind of thing to tackle, make sure I was
you had your stuff in
secure
order.
Enough.
Yes. Yeah.
So I tried to see everything through before I fully, you know. It was kind of a jump, but it was kind of, you know, I had some padding down.
You had a foundation.
You know, yeah. So, you know, I passed the test, I was doing hair out of the house, and then I was like, okay, now it's time for me to be able to separate my work life from, you know, like my personal life. Because I was at the house doing hair.
Yeah.
I was trapping off the same phone. Not trapping,
trapping, but what that means? Trapping off the phone.
Yeah,
DJ, we know what that is. Love it. Okay.
I was doing business, personal life.
I got a new word, Lynette Holly. Don't use that word. Don't. Oh, scratch.
So I was, you know, everything is just all together, mixed okay. together. And yeah. it was kind of, it wasn't really stressful, but it was almost like suffocating.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't a right, like it wasn't a division between yeah. the two. So yeah.
you, got your family life and your business life.
Yeah, it had to be separate.
Yeah.
So then I,
You had attitudes. We'll let you know. You were frustrated.
Jamaya came in the house all day.
All day.
No sun. I wasn't stepping out the house because I was taking two clients a day.
You were having your business.
Booked and busy. So it was just kind of like,
yeah.
you know, I need, at least let me commute to work.
Go to work in the car.
How many
want to be business like, be busy like that? You know, have business like just overflowing. Like I can't even get out the house.
Then that's when I went and I looked for the suite, and I kind of found it and signed the papers to the lease like within the same week.
You know, you had the money. That's boss mode. You go.
But I did have to kind of budget.
Yeah.
So at first I was gonna, you know, get my own apartment, but then I was like, you know, let's kind of do this. Yeah. So I did that, and then I had to hope and pray that I would continue to be, you know, making as much money as I could to make sure I could now pay for this space.
See, we don't move by faith. Yeah, we don't move by faith to fail.
Exactly.
Like when you are moving by faith, that is a sign to say that there is more that God has for you. Mm-hmm. And it always looks funny because the Father, God won't tell you everything on the other side. But when you move by faith, that leap of faith allows you to be in His zone because you can't trust yourself at that point no more.
Yes.
All your trust is in Him.
Yes.
Yeah, but just you have to have that confidence, like you said, that I'm not going to do less, but I'm going to do more. And this is what this move is about, to handle more.
Yes.
So you're already, you're in a shop now.
Yes.
What days of the week? Let them know. When do you go?
Monday, Tuesday. I take Wednesdays off. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday I do a half day.
Wow.
However, I may adjust the schedule a little bit, but right now that's the time. My hours are normally I take one at 9 in the morning and then one at 4 p.m.
Okay. Wow. And how your fingers doing? You good?
I'm holding on.
Yeah.
Sometimes I get a little pain in my wrist, but...
So you need to handle that now. You need to get everything you need now to secure.
I wear a brace every now and then, but it doesn't hurt as much as it was at one point.
Because, I can understand.
So it's just better. It's getting, you know...
Yeah, but. You do it. God bless those hands. I just want to know that you are so blessed right now in the name of Jesus. No weapon formed against you shall prosper.
Amen.
That you will do this as long as you desire to do it.
Yes.
And that the clients is coming.
Yes.
Anything else that you want to say before we end this show? Any shout outs?
Shout out to everyone. I want to say shout out to everyone that's booked with me.
Okay.
Everyone that comes back.
You better
back.
Talk to your Instagram.
Everyone that comes back. Shout out. I'm just very appreciative because, you know, when you start something on your own, you really don't know. Mm-hmm. You know, you have people coming, but you really don't know how many people actually support you.
Yeah.
And I thank a lot of my clients because they really do. They tell me and they show me how much they support me. And that honestly means a lot to me. And that's what keeps me going. Because sometimes, you know, it gets hard.
Yeah.
You get tired. You want to stop. But you just always have to remember, you started for a reason. You have a plan. God put something in you. So, like you said, the faith, when you have faith, you give it to God and you step out and you just kind of, you keep going.
Yeah, and I love the fact that you appreciate them. I think it's very important as a professional, when you're in a profession, to appreciate your clients because there's so many other people they could go to.
Exactly.
There's so many other, and when you say, I appreciate you, and you know what I'm saying, and they show that love back to you, that's building a relationship.
Exactly.
And that's what we do in business, and that's what I love to do is build relationships.
Yes.
All right. You guys, go follow _braided_goddess_ and reach out to Jamaya and let her hook you up. It's summertime about to come, you guys.
Y'all come
you know she's
going
to be busy. Yeah, you better book in advance, you guys. Thank you so much, Jamaya, for joining us here tonight on Pillow Talks. And we will see you increasing.
Thank you so much.
Good night, you guys.